here again. Welcome back to another AMI tutorial. Today we're going to go over a new feature called Event Mode. Now, I'm going to tell you all about Event Mode because it's pretty cool. Imagine you've got karaoke night, trivia night, or a big sporting event, and some reason you don't want the jukebox to be playing music. We've created Event Mode for you to be able to stifle that, to be able to halt selections and playback on the jukeboxes. Now you might ask yourself, look, why don't I just turn the jukebox off or pull the plug? That's how we've been handling stuff like this for ages. As much as I appreciate that, I do want to let you know that we want to discourage that for a few reasons. For starters, you never want to pull the plug on the jukebox because it may be talking to the servers at the moment that you do it, which is never a good outcome. Next, you lose screen time. And the reason screen time is important to you as well as the bar is you've spent time or the bar has spent time making the local ads through Ad Manager. And if the jukebox screen isn't running, people aren't seeing those ads. Next, speaking of ads, we have paid ads going to the jukeboxes. And if the jukebox isn't on or the screen isn't running, there's no chance for you to run those ads and gain revenue through that stream. Finally, and this is the big one, your patrons, they might have jukebox selections already made. And when they walk over to that jukebox and they see that it's turned off, then they're going to start coming to the bar or complaining about not getting what they paid for. When we use Event Mode, they will get a notification on their phone and text will show up on the jukebox saying that this jukebox is temporarily disabled and that the selections already made will pick up as soon as the event is over with. That's kind of the reason why we're really excited about this feature, because it really gives you all the control. Let's talk about what the bar goer is going to see when we're in Event Mode. Let's say they're using the mobile app. Well, what it's going to show is that the jukebox is currently offline, even though we know the jukebox is still turned on. Now, on the jukebox itself, the bill acceptor and the credit card readers are both going to stop accepting payments. And on the jukebox, they'll see this message, which will also tell them when the event is going to end so that they know when paid selections are coming back. Hopefully now I've sold you on the idea of Event Mode. Because if I haven't, there might be some software developers that are really mad at me if you don't use it. So consider it. Now you're probably wondering how you're supposed to do that. Well, it's all done through Copilot. If you don't have Copilot, we'll have a link in the description of this video. Let me take you over there. All right, let's get to it. Go ahead and log yourself into Copilot. And once you're there, you're going to view all locations. Scroll until you find the location you want to use. And then select it and the jukebox if necessary. Select control system. And now event mode. Now that you're in event mode, we're going to start with selecting the time. The start time is always going to be now. Let's go ahead and go with 1 o'clock. Perfect. Next, we're going to go and pick out our label. For fun, I think I want to go ahead and pick Trivia Night. Next, you're going to hit the back button. And it's time to decide how we want the jukebox to behave. This is important in case you need to use auxiliary. You can tell the jukebox to continue using any one of these things below. But if you want it completely off, simply select Do Not Use. Now we're ready to activate. Click Activate Now, and then Continue. There, event mode is on. Now that we're back in control system, you can see that event mode is in fact enabled. Now if you need to, you can edit or deactivate the event by clicking edit or deactivate event. In there, you can edit or change what parts of the jukebox are able to be used or update the time or even the event. Any changes you want to make, you can make within this area. When you're ready, click save changes and continue. And you're back to where you were. Now let's say you want to deactivate the event entirely. Well, go back in, at the bottom you see in red, deactivate now, and continue. This will deactivate your event. Most likely to be bar staff using this feature as events tend to run long or short and they can deactivate when they need to. Finally, we have provided an option for you to toggle on notifications that will let you know when an event is initiated.
just tap the settings icon in the top right of your screen. Click Notifications, and then find Event Mode Entered, and turn it from left to right. You can also tap to make that work. There you have it.
Finally, there's one last thing I feel like I should tell you about. This feature upgrade will also be initiated automatically every time your jukebox is paused for longer than 5 minutes, meaning that you won't accept payments or song selections during a pause. Now, pausing is different from a timed event in that it can be initiated from the remote or from Copilot, and it usually has an expire time in a smaller amount of time. The default is 10 minutes, but you can kind of set your own pause duration in service mode on the jukebox. Once again, we hope that you found this video tutorial useful. Make sure to subscribe to our channel so that you can get updates about any other tutorials that come out. Feel free to poke around and check out some of the other ones we've already made. And remember, call 877-762-6765 for technical support with AMI Entertainment. Again, I'm Harry, and I hope you all have a wonderful day.